Good morning. Today's Friday, the 30th of October, and it's a Feria. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty, ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen. And in the readings of the Feria, yesterday we finished the reading of the letter of Paul to the Ephesians, and today we start the reading of the letter to the Philippians, Christians at Philippi. It begins with, "From Paul and Timothy, servants of Christ Jesus, to all the saints in Christ Jesus, together with their presiding elders and deacons, we wish you the grace and peace of God our Father and of our Lord Jesus Christ." And it goes on to a wonderful phrase. "My prayer is that your love for each other may increase more and more and never stop improving your knowledge and deepening your perception so that you can always recognize what is best. This will help you to become pure and blameless and prepare you for the day of Christ when you will reach the perfect goodness which Jesus Christ produces in us for the glory and praise of Christ." The word of the Lord. In the Gospel, we've moved on to a new chapter in Luke now, chapter 14, verses 1 to 6. "Now on a Sabbath day, Jesus had gone for a meal to the house of one of the leading Pharisees, and they watched him closely. There in front of him was a man with dropsy, and Jesus addressed the lawyers and Pharisees. 'Is it against the law,' he asked, 'to cure a man on the Sabbath or not?' But they remained silent. So he took the man and cured him and sent him away. Then he said to them, 'Which of you here, if his son falls into a well or his ox, will not pull him out on a Sabbath day without hesitation?' And to this they could find no answer." The Gospel of the Lord. Begin with the Gospel. We've had a similar story already of Jesus challenging the lawyers and the Pharisees about healing on the Sabbath. And here it's very specific. He goes to this, invited there for dinner, and there's a man there with dropsy, and they're watching him very closely. And Jesus takes up the situation, asks them the question, is it right or wrong to do this? Cures the man. And then makes the same point as he made the previous time. Any of you, if your ox or your son fell into a hole in the ground, you would pull them out, wouldn't you? And he makes the point that the rules regarding the Sabbath are to serve the Sabbath, not to dominate it. And that the spirit of the law is to love God and love our neighbour. And that we certainly are able, as mature thinking human beings, to make the decision about what the law means when faced with the circumstances of healing or helping somebody out of a hole. The letter to the Philippians is a very joyful letter. It begins with that beautiful phrase to all the saints in Philippi. It refers to the elders and deacons, and it's important to know that the present structure and clergy of bishops, priests and deacons was very fluid in the early church, and they hadn't settled down to any pattern. And the fact that this elders or bishops are in the plural is quite clear that it's more likely to refer to celebrants, priests, rather than bishops. The custom became quite soon that there should only be one bishop for an area. Anyway, it's to do with the growth in the church. But that phrase that I read from the first one about how in peace Paul says that your love of Jesus and your love for each other is a remarkable thing that I rejoice in seeing and hearing about. He tells them, again, he's in prison on the way to Rome, but that it brings him great joy that they are a community that's strong, that's growing in love. And perhaps that's the learning for today, that we've had so many epistles and gospels warning us about the end of time and being ready for a sudden death, etc. Always be prepared with our lamps lit. Here, Paul is saying, you're doing fine. You're on the journey. You're not there yet. But I can see that you're growing in love of God and loving each other. I encourage you to continue in this growth. But equally, I give thanks that you found your place, that you're a community committed to Christ. And for us, this is probably a good message to say, we should never be too anxious about our growth. As long as we're doing our bit to try to pray each day, try to keep the commandments, try to go to church whenever we can, we're on the right road, and therefore we needn't be anxious about it, though equally we shouldn't take it too much for granted. But the very beginning prayers, as we'll say in a moment, you'll see it's all about finding peace, and that we have every right to find peace in the love of God as we journey towards Him. So we turn to our bidding prayers now. The response is, Father, in your will is our peace. Father, in your will is our peace. Father, we praise you for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself in sacrifice to you, that we might be delivered from death and selfishness, and be free to live in your peace. Father, in your will is our peace. We accept this new day as your gift, Lord. Grant that we may live in newness of life. Father, in your will is our peace. You made all things and keep all things in being. Give us the insight to see your hand at work in them all. Father, in your will is our peace. Your Son sealed the new and everlasting covenant in his blood. Help us to live by this covenant and honour it. Father, in your will is our peace. As Jesus died on the cross, blood and water flowed from his side. As we share in the Eucharist, pour out your Spirit upon us. Father, in your will is our peace. And this is how Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Almighty God, as in this morning prayer, we offer you our praise. Grant that in your kingdom, together with your saints, we may praise you with ever greater joy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace and have a good day. Bye.